Great achievers are ordinary people with extraordinary ambition.
A dramatic, famous victory here for the world champion Wallabies.
10 months ago, the finest athletes on earth gathered here at Stadium Australia. Time and again, the will of the human spirit was stretched to breaking point. But ultimately, it was the greatest who prevailed. And so it will be tonight.
He's around Latham. Oh, what a sensational start.
Battered and brushed aside in the first test at the Gabba, John Eel's gallant men struck back with extraordinary ambition last weekend in AFL Heartland.
Joe Robb, looking for number two!
But now it's back to square one. The pride of Lions from Britain and Ireland will also push themselves to breaking point. It's a night for greatness and glory when Tom Richards, a pioneering British Lion and Wallaby legend, lends his name to a rugby showdown made in heaven. What a night for the time-honoured game that was first liberated at rugby school back in the early 19th century. An estimated television audience of 500 million to witness a sporting epic here in Sydney. The Bundaberg Rum Test Series reaching a crescendo as the Wallaby and the Lion square off for world rugby supremacy. Well, welcome to Seven's coverage, and this is the summit clash of two hemispheres. And can the Wallabies tame the Lions after more than 100 years of frustration? Or will the finest players from England, Ireland, Scotland and Wales leave our shores triumphant? The Wallabies arrived a short time ago. They have been based at Coogee earlier in the week, and then they moved late in the week to Parramatta, and very grim-faced, but still quite relaxed as they are in terrific battle for this big showdown tonight. Well, very shortly, we'll hear from our passionate experts, Simon Poitevin and Chris Handy, but we're bringing in Gary Pearce now, former Wallaby flanker, to just analyse proceedings of what might happen and where can you see the edge for both sides, Gary?
Gordon, it's going to be a titanic struggle of two conflicting styles. The Lions are going to be powerful, uncompromising, and at times really ruthless out there. While the Wallabies, I think you'll find, will be expansive, open, and they'll be a really, really hard team to beat. You'll find that the Lions will use this wedge again. They really do drive it through the middle, as we saw in the first test, but not just in one direction. They'll move it off to other directions once they see a lot of goal jumpers around, and they'll shift it to the right or the left. Normally the back rowers are the quicker, more powerful players who will take it off the edges as they keep the ball off the ground and commit the players. The Wallabies will show a defensive line right across the field as they showed in the test, but you'll find that the Lions can adapt to this. In this case, they were able to delay a ball, which meant that the Wallaby forwards, the spot Wallaby defenders came up and took out the players, but opened up a gap with a deep running player right through the middle.
So we see the driving maul from the Lions and also the ability of the Wallabies to defend in midfield, crucial areas. What about from Australia's point of view?
Well, it's all about the Wallabies going up to fifth gear. They started off in a very lacklustre way in the first test. They tried to play it deep and away from the advantage line. So they loaded their players out wide and tried cut-out passes. It really was ineffective, and it just didn't get us anywhere in that first test. But in the second test, we're a wake-up, and our forwards really came to the fore. And you see here the loose head taking it up, disrupting the Lions. But the Lions trying to break away to get this wedge running again. But the Wallabies take him to ground quickly, very quickly, because they know how dangerous that can be as it moves forward. Lions come through to clear out, but it's more of a stagnate situation rather than it was before. But the real cutting edge comes with the Wallabies, where they play the mini ruck, mini maul game, where they play it at a faster pace than the Lions. And it keeps putting back that Lions defence. Each time the ball pops out, ball goes, comes out very quickly. Plenty of runners coming onto the ball, let they be forwards or backs. But as they commit players, they move it forward, players go to that point, defenders go to it, move the ball away from it, opens up for a great try from Burke.
So summing up, can you give us a winner in tonight's big clash, Gary Pearce?
Well, of course, it's a hometown for the Wallabies, but it's going to be a tremendous clash. And I just think the power of the Lions up front and that expansive, creative game of the Wallabies really is going to come through at the end.
Well, thanks very much, Gary. We'll hear from you at halftime and again at full time. But the Lions arrived, and they've been based at the seaside as well, out at Manly. They were there before the match against the Waratahs. They've had quite a few setbacks. It's been a tour of controversy for them, with some of the players being very outspoken. And Johnny Wilkinson, a guy who really has to come through that injury cloud and prove his quality here tonight. But really, it's death or glory for both teams. We'll be back shortly at Stadium Australia.
But if we win tonight, if we don't win tonight, it's a done coup.
We know we've got a job to do out there today, and as I say, the preparation's been good, but it's a matter of putting it on the field now.
Well, we're back at Stadium Australia, and it's a capacity sellout of 84,000. And joining me now is Simon Poitevin. We've seen dramatic swings of the pendulum in the first two Test matches. Where is the balance of power for Australia tonight?
Well, the big factors tonight are firstly the stadium. The Wallabies love playing here and they've had great success here. Secondly, the defence, in-the-face defence last week, really unsettled the Lions. They'll do it again tonight. Thirdly, injuries. The Wallabies four, they're a weakened outfit. And finally, the Rod McQueen factor. Rod McQueen will be a very emotional man tonight. So will the team.
Well, here we are in the dressing room, and as you say, it is emotional. Very quiet dressing room. Big night for Elton Flatley, Justin Harrison.
Yeah, both young players, but players of superb skills and also attitude. There's Rod McQueen, Ewan McKenzie. What a journey for Rod McQueen tonight.
Okay, well, let's now take you down to the touchline and Chris Handy. And Buddha, you're hardly a social butterfly, but you've had a busy round of engagements this week, and that lion tamer suit has been getting a real workout. But seriously, can the Lions crack the whip for a famous victory tonight?
Well, Gordon, they've used some big long words to describe this game tonight. For me, it's brutal and somewhat sadistic. It's scrum and line out up front that will decide it. Two defensive lines that will try and smash each other out of the game. And that is what I think everybody's come to see here at Stadium Australia. All the supporters have been out in their numbers. You just couldn't see the town for red jerseys all the week leading up. It's been quite special.
Well, Buddha, what about Campo's shop? Campo threw that pass in 1989 at the SFS, and the Lions fans have been giving him heaps.
Well, Gordon, it's just been a crush outside there all week. Lions. But it's their big men that you can see here that they want the performance from at Stadium Australia. There's been a war of words going on around the place, but that's all over. It's decided in 80 minutes on this paddock tonight, and I just can't wait. Bring it on.
Yes, well, the Lions and the Australians first met in a series back in 1899. This is the final countdown to the final showdown. The last time they met was 12 years ago, and that series was the one that got away.
Something that I'm proud to have done was play against the British Lions in a series at home, which not many players in Australia have ever done. I was disappointed in having lost the series. We won the first test fairly comfortably. Then the second and third were very close. And more was lost by mistakes on our part than by sort of good play from the opposition. But I look back on it now, as I do with most rugby games and series, with fondness, whether we won or lost. There's a great anticipation that this Australian side that has won just about every trophy they've competed in over the last 2 years has one last hurdle to overcome, and that's the British Lions side, brimming with wonderful players and great depth.
Deciding test match, the series locked at 1-1. Well, you can certainly hear the fans. There are 84,000. It's a global audience. Over 2 million people watching here in Australia. And wide screens have been installed all over the country to watch the Seven telecast. A special cheerio to our 1,500 Australian Defence Force personnel watching the telecast in East Timor. Our troops are making sure that the East Timorese are safe and secure before the elections in August. And if you think that the TV soapies are big here, what about in Europe? As the Lions found out, Home and Away on the Seven Network is bigger than Ben-Hur. Richard Hill, Rob Howley, two of the world-class Lions who've been injured and forced out of this game, meeting the cast of Home and Away and really relishing the moment. So let's now see how the two sides line up tonight. And both teams have been disrupted, which has been most unfortunate. There's even been a late change to the Welsh lineup. But firstly, the Australian team, and it's the same front row from Colonial Stadium, Melbourne. Nick Stiles, Michael Foley, and Rod Moore. In the second row, what a night for Justin Harrison, his first test cap alongside John Eales. In the back row, the flankers are Owen Finnegan, and 21 today, George Smith. Todd Aikefu making up the back row at number 8. George Gregan now the second most capped scrum half in history. Elton Flatley, his first run-on start since 97. And the blockbusting centre pairing of Nathan Gray and Daniel Herbert, all aggression. And Joe Roff, he was the man of the match last week at Colonial, 2 tries. And Andrew Walker looking for action tonight as well, with Matthew Burke, 25 points against the Lions in the second test. That's the most points ever against the Lions in their history, which dates back to 1888. And talking of the visitors, let's see how they line up now. There were suggestions they might change their front row, but not so. Tom Smith, the lone Scotsman in the 15, with Irishman Keith Wood and the raging bull Bill Vickery. All English locking combination in the second row. Johnson captain Danny Grucock. And 2 more guys from England, both Leicester, Martin Corrie, Neil Back, and the lone Welshman before the late change, Scott Quinnell at number 8. Matt Dawson, former England captain, coming in for Howley at scrum half. Johnny Wilkinson's been under an injury cloud, but great to see him there. The all-Irish centre pairing of Rob Henderson and the brilliant Brian O'Driscoll, man of the match at the Gabba. And Jason Robinson, the Englishman, is joined by a late inclusion, Darford James, who comes in for Austin Healey, and Matt Perry is the fullback. So all in all, there are 522 caps for both country and the Lions in the tourists' lineup here tonight. Well, it's going to be a very emotional night for the Wallaby coach, Rod McQueen. He has grabbed every international trophy available since he took over the reins in 1997. The only one missing is the Tom Richards Cup, and it's up for grabs tonight at his final curtain call. And that is the majestic scene from Stadium Australia, and at the far end there, you can see the army of Lions supporters, but it seems as though the gold supporters are surrounding the perimeter. They are closest to the playing field, so it's going to be a battle of voices as far as the barracking goes. But this 84,000 is below the world record attendance of 109,000 here at Stadium Australia for the Bledisloe Cup. And now, Martin Johnson leading out his Lions. These players will disband after this game and return to their countries. This is their last shot at the big prize. Once in a lifetime opportunity. Scott Quinnell, one of 2 Welshmen in the side, and Neil Back. That's Martin Johnson with the team mascots, arrives at the Olympic Stadium. Calm and composed. Several of these Lions players have been through a 3 test series against another country. That was the Lions tour in South Africa, 97. Johnson led that tour. He's the first man to lead back-to-back Lions tours, and hoping to be the first man also to do it twice in a row. But as we look at the Lions team, and in the front row, it's the same tight 5. They're led by the experienced Keith Wood and Captain Johnson. Curry coming in at number 6 for the concussed Richard Hill. In the backs, Dawson replaces the injured Howley, whilst Healey is a late dropout, and Darford James comes in. Now, in the run-on side, we have three Irish, 10 English, and just one each from Wales and Scotland. Scott Quinnell, Simon Poitevin, a key figure tonight.
Yeah, Scott Quinnell, a giant man, very mobile, has been used great effect to batter into the Australian backs.
And there's Matt Dawson. Now, he scored a brilliant try in the first test at Cape Town for the Lions to set up the series victory back in 1997. He comes in for the injured Rob Howley. Great atmosphere. Chris Handy down on the touchline. But firstly, Matthew Burke leading out the Wallaby team on this the occasion of his 50th international in the Australian jumper. Justin Harrison there, his first cap tonight. The crowd set to erupt. It was Daniel Herbert in his 50th test last week. This time, Matthew Burke on July 14, 2001. And both sides just soaking up the atmosphere as the glitterati, the confetti, coloured gold rains down on Stadium Australia. Elton Flatley there, Chris Handy. It's a huge moment for him as we look at this Australian team. There are no changes to the front row that did so well last week. In the second row, debutant Justin Harrison replacing the injured Gibbon. And he joins John Eales, who equals Willie John's world record of 80 caps at lock. In the backs, Gregan, now the second most cap scrum half of all time. And Elton Flatley coming in for his first run-on test in 4 years. 471 run-on caps in the starting side. And Justin Harrison, it's the greatest night of his rugby career. He was described by Austin Healey as an eight. But one South African commentator, I think, was closer to the mark. He said he's a giraffe on steroids. And Elton Flatley, well, Chris Handy, you know a lot about this young guy. He's trained brilliantly this week.
All the disappointments that he's had in missing selection and some injuries will be out the door at this particular moment. This young man won't let the Wallabies down.
So Colin Chavis coming in onto the bench. He was suspended, you'll recall. But yeah, it's all about savouring the occasion now. Last time together on tour, a lot of experience in this Lions team. And as we get down to the engine room, more poker faced. Tommy Smith there, the man they call Tom Thumb, underneath the left armpit of Martin Johnson. Anthony Warlow, celebrated Australian recording artist, now to perform the national anthem. And there is Andy Nicol in the middle. He's come in as a late replacement with Austin Healey coming off. He's been leading a supporters group. He joined the squad this morning. Classic Australian voice rings round the Olympic Stadium. And the Wallabies now to go in a huddle. And ferocity there from Phil Vickery as we look at the reserves bench. And on the right there, 21, Andy Nicol, called into the Lions squad this morning. He's been a tour leader with supporters groups. And across on the left-hand side, he's opposite James Holbeck, also called into the side with the withdrawal of Stephen Larkham. Chris Whittaker hasn't been on in the series so far. Brendan Cannon came on for his first test last week. So the crowd breaking out into Waltzing Matilda. And we'll just enjoy a few moments here with Troy Cassidale.
Jump the swag, grab him with glee.
Chris Handy, you've been very close to the Australians since they've taken the fields. And these guys have talked about taking the moment, making the most of the achievement, as Troy Cassar-Daly is lampooned by a lion's scar. I hope that's not an omen for the Australians.
Well, that's an early test down here. They've shown the flag, the red badge of courage, and that man in the middle, Paddy O'Brien, he's got to manage it.
Well, he comes from a place they call the bottom of the world, Invercargill in New Zealand, but tonight Paddy is on top of the world, the biggest match of his career. As the players eyeball now, looking at their opposite number, Joe Rock, who performed so splendidly, and little Tom Thumb, Torai Kepu, had a big game with Owen Finnegan. So Andrew Walker to get proceedings underway. It's the championship decider, Australia and the Lions in 2001. Very high ball from Walker. Grewcock is there, and the crumbs picked up by Keith Wood, just out from the 22. Johnny Wilkinson goes wide early. Surprise tactics, but a loose pass. Robinson cleans up. The Lions have put themselves under pressure early on. Matt Dawson. Did the Wallabies come through prematurely? It looked like it. And there's the penalty first up.
The Lions showing their hand. Jason Robinson, their star player. Got no ball last week. They're going to use him tonight. This is fantastic. Sets a huge stage for the Wallabies to defend.
Good, and like a false start at the Olympics, that one. This stadium out of the blocks too quickly, the Wallabies.
But great to see that intention of adventure. And there, George Smith, Nathan Gray, number one also, Nick Stiles, all coming through before the ball was cleared from the scrum, all offside.
This phase is a weapon for the Lions, the line out. They've been able to take it cleanly, bring it down and move it forward off the mark. And see if they try it right from the outset.
Pinched there by Justin Harrison, his first touch in a test match. That's a big strike for the Australians. Now Finnegan makes it to the advantage line. Now, they've been ruled offside, coming up inside the 10 metres from the line of touch because the line-out had not finished, says referee Paddy O'Brien. Early penalty, Australia.
And good tactic too, taking the pressure off flatly, basically getting to Finnegan. Finnegan takes the first ball up, gets smashed, but they're offside.
What about the wonderful win by Justin Harrison at the middle? They called him an ape, and I'll have one of these with arms that long in my team any time.
Yes, well, against the run of play, Justin Harrison inspired Pilfer. And suddenly the Wallabies poised to post first points in this enormous occasion for both sides. Matthew Burke, before this series, had had his last start at fullback in the Rugby World Cup final, 1999. Six penalty goals, a record last week in Melbourne. Crowd likes it. So inside the third minute, and it's the Wallabies leading by 3-0.
Well, Justin Harrison may be young and inexperienced, but that first line out, and watch this kick from Matthew Burke. Super cool.
Knocked ahead by Danny Grewcock. He is flatly now. Oh, hit hard there by Wilkinson. Referee playing advantage.
Lost five by Reid, no bunch out of it.
So no advantage there for the Australians.
Elton flatly down, injured and back play.
Gentlemen.
Well, as Paul McLean said during the week, if you put 10 on your back, you're open game for most. Flatly took it forward hard. It'll be interesting to see what the injury is.
Okay, it's 3-0 Australia with Flatley in trouble. And sadly for Elton Flatley, he has been quite injury prone in recent seasons. He suffered a broken jaw on the Wallaby Tour last year when he was set to play against England.
Huge hit there from Johnny Wilkinson. This will be a game of massive defence. The kickoff, and there Grewcock puts the ball forward.
gentlemen, just wait, please. No.
Flatley took it up and met in a strong tackle from Johnny Wilkinson.
So he just looked to be receiving a knock on the head. Nothing in it.
Come up.
Teething masses Chris Handy in the first scrum.
Oh, look, this is where it's decided. And they know everyone trying to take just the slightest millimetre of advantage. Wallaby scrum holds strong.
Yeah, but sloppy ball at the back. Nathan Gray. So that was a huge scrum from the Lions. Australia forced to scurry. And now a line out on the 22 with the Lions throw.
That's the high risk scoop here by Tote Kefu. Back to George Gregan. Didn't give Nathan Gray too much time. They'll take this down and drive it.
That's Martin Corrie at the back. Now they go wide. Big tackle by Nathan Gray. Henderson bounced out of that tackle. Wallaby swarm in. So some nice, calm refereeing from Paddy O'Brien.
Sensational tackle, Owen Finnegan on Dawson. Enveloped him.
Well, that's what has to happen. He's a danger man, Dawson. They've got to mark him up close. Gray's got to make his first up tackles.
Very low Wallaby scrum. It's Quinnell into Gregan. He's made 7 metres. This is Robinson from the left wing. Flatley the tackler. Matt Dawson. Corrie is 10 metres out. Gregan doing plenty of talking here to marshal the defence. Henderson, clever kick. He was taken out, says the referee. And I tell you what, if he hadn't have been taken out, there was no one in front of him. The weight of that kick meant that he could have easily have fallen on it and scored the try.
Like Michael Foley, the man, Henderson, charges through, and there it is, a little hip from Foley.
Clever work by Henderson at close quarters. He ran into some traffic there. He got the benefit of it from Paddy O'Brien, and now Wilkinson, a gift opportunity.
Well, you'd have to say the Wallabies struck the first psychological blow with the poaching in the line-out. The Lions put Australia's scrum under pressure in the first scrum. And this should level up the scores for Johnny Wilkinson and the Lions. Listen to the roar. This army of Lions supporters, unofficially estimated at somewhere near 40,000 following their heroes here down under.
Certainly an army of occupation here in Sydney.
Splendid riposte from the Lions. 3-3. Andrew Walker goes the 10. Johnson. Aerial skills of an Aussie rules ruckman. And Australia pulled it to ground. Dawson plays on quickly. Darford James in behind the Aussies. Dawson wants the quick ball. Henderson back. Corrie went without it. Oh, missed opportunity there for the Lions.
Often we've seen those errors come when the Lions most need them to stick. A little lack of concentration. They'll either split you up the middle or spill the ball.
Yeah, Rod Moore has to be careful. He pulled that Lions rumbling maul down.
Very low scrum again for the Aussies. It's solid. Nathan Gray stepping through the first tackle of Matt Dawson. Finnegan straight into Wilkinson. There's Kefu and Smith hit hard by Quinnell. Burks come in. Kefu throws a dummy. Intercepted by Dawson. Clever kick. Well, Australia threatening to score a try there, but Dawson got in the way. There's a good reply from Burke. It's out on the full though, just. And the Lions with the momentum.
Matthew Burke caught that ball just a metre out from the 25. Couldn't take it back. George Smith. Watch him get hit here.
They're looking for Smith. They need to take him out of the game, and they'll have to try a bit harder than that. Great break down the short side by Todai Kepu.
Harrison got it again. His second steal in the line-out. Brilliant timing there from the new boy, Justin Harrison, on the Lions' throw. And now Joe Roth with a rifling torpedo. This is Matt Perry. Harrison in front. Flatley comes in. Elton Flatley getting very involved in defence. Wilkinson now. Hefty kick downfield. Nasty bounce. Matthew Burke. Henderson from Ireland. He's Andrew Walker. Scored a brilliant try at the Gabba. A quiet game before being concussed last week. Or knocked in the head. Scott Quinnell now. Walker goes low. Grassed him. What a tackle there by Walker, who is half the size of Scott Quinnell at 120 kilos.
Well, they knew Robinson wasn't going to return the kick because it's a skill that he's been struggling with. And Scott Quinnell looked a little reluctant to cart it up. And a little bit of pressure put on by the following man.
This tackle's all about technique. 120 kilos rumbling up the field. It just comes in low.
So the scores are locked at 3-3 here at Stadium Australia. Stadium Australia is being reconfigured at a cost of $70 million, hence those empty seats. It'll be ready in 2003. And the capacity will be around 84,000, which are in tonight. Extra seats have been brought in. Matthew Burke's on target. Second success for the Aussie fullback. He continues on his point-scoring spree. 6-3.
The Australians ahead, but good attitude from the Lions. They want to spread this ball tonight.
Justin Harrison with a brilliant take overhead. The Lions wanting to play on quickly. Now George Gregan's gone in behind. Who wants it? Dawson didn't. Gregan's there.
Touch judge has got his flag out. Steve Walsh Jr. on this side of the field.
Maybe someone was taken out without the ball there. We'll wait and see. Wilkinson now. And Burke waiting for this kick near the 22. Just getting a better angle for the touch line. And then a drop punt. Not getting the touch. This is Perry. Burke in for the tackle. Halfway line. And there's a touch judge report from this side. Steve Walsh Jr., New Zealand.
It was on the kickoff, and the game is halted until this report is made. The touch judge has a microphone in the top of his flag.
After Bold had taken the ball down from the kickoff, Spike Reed came in and the knee into the back of the white.
At the kickoff?
Sorry, the number one yellow flag.
I'm going to penalise him. You got to remain.
Yes, I will.
All right.
You just spoke between no cards, but
knees are back.
So the call was against number five, Martin Johnson.
Knees in the back, number five. Number five, please.
Let's see.
I think it was
Danny Grukop.
Danny Grukop, and he led with the knee. That's a shocker. Have a look where he comes in here. Not attempting to go for the ball, and the knee straight into the back of number one. It's a cheap one.
Well, the other thing which is concerning about that, he is a black belt in karate, and they had karate all about it.
Yes, well, he's the second Englishman to have been sent off in a test match, and that was for stomping Anton Oliver, the All Black captain. So Danny Grukop, the karate black belt, striking out with his knee that time. There's the drop punt kit from Andrew Walker, gaining 35 metres. Australia ahead 6-3.
Well, the Australians tried that in a previous test, and this time goes forward. Finnegan on the march, but ball goes down.
Forgettable execution there from the Australians. Big wheel from the Aussie scrum. Now the Lions have to use it. That's Scott Quinnell. Now, once you're on the ground and there are players on their feet from the opposition side, you must let it go. And there's Harrison and Johnson. Well, Justin Harrison, keen to get into the action early in his test debut.
Justin Harrison did well, then he restrained himself with a real hold on his throat.
Heavy on your number four.
Fantastic work, George Smith. Forced a turnover. Watch him. Ball comes forward. George Smith in over number seven now. Quinnell doesn't release. That's where the penalty comes.
Yes, sir, I'm sure there'll be a word in Justin Harrison's ear to just cool it down as Matthew Burke lines up for another penalty attempt. A chance to put Australia ahead by 9-3. The score is 6-3 to Australia. Burke has kicked two penalties, looking for his third here. 25 points last week. Handy position. This to put Australia out by six. Faultless. So Australia punishing. Indiscretions by the Lions. 9-3.
Oh, goody, that ball's just flowing so beautifully off the boot tonight. Matthew Burke unerring. He wasn't striking it so sweetly last week.
Yes, well, he's really relishing this summit ball, which wasn't used in the Super 12. There's a knock-on by Andrew Walker, just taking his eye off the ball, and that puts the pressure back on the Aussies.
The Australians having Andrew Walker back there. He's got a big boot. Just had a look that time. Ball goes down. Now the Lions. Fantastic attacking position.
Those two front rows really charging in. Dawson then for Wilkinson. Here's Perry out wide. Burke and Robinson. Well, they put him into space. It was one-on-one, but Australia closed him down. Scott Quinnell, 7 metres out. Dawson through a dummy. Finnegan going in for it. They've slowed it down. It was a tackle. Australia pointing out the ball had come out on their side.
Lions.
The referee's decision had been made.
Lions falling into almost some obstruction off the edge of that. A couple of players getting in the way, but really testing the Wallaby defence. They came at it off the edges, firstly Quinnell, and then with some support, Owen Finnegan gets his measure.
No line breaks on either side so far. Australia has kicked seven times in general play to the Lions three. The Lions keen to run the ball tonight. Had a little more possession and a lot more territory, but Australia is ahead on the scoreboard.
This defence there on Jason Robinson, and two goal jumpers to bring him down.
Nick Stiles on this side has been strong against Vickery. He's been able to take that scrum around. They won't want to kick this back row off too far, though.
Come up. I'm gone. I'm going to start the game. Hold. Game.
The Lions again. And now the Aussie scrum. They're going for the pushover. It's on here for the Lions.
Come on. It's fine to stay in.
Well, both sofas locked up then, so the referee brings it back and resets.
Referee a bit to blame for holding that initial contact up. Now we'll see the relative strengths of both scrums.
Australia goes down and is given the benefit of the doubt. But you could see the crunch coming on there, Chris.
Plenty of pressure. The Lions now should take it to the Wallabies and keep it at them. And this will be the test.
Well, for Paddy, and this is a Fiji and France in the World Cup back in 1999, a match he'd want to forget. He's going to make a decision here one way or the other, I feel, if it goes down again. Here's Wilkinson and Henderson. 5 metres out. Wallabies lying all over it. Slowing it down. Here's Dawson and Wilkinson. There's 3-on-2 here. Overlap. It has to be a try. Robinson! They've got him into space a couple of times. And a telling strike back by the Lions.
It's a concentration of goal defence in close, which leaves Keith Wood out wide. And then a quick pass. Watch it go wide. Wilkson, nice switch. Tom Smith, and then Jason Robinson, George Gregan notes.
As soon as Andrew Walker came in, it was all over. Rodmore couldn't move across quickly enough to cover Wood. Great try to the Lions.
Well, it was classic vision by Johnny Wilkinson. He sent the ball initially to the right, and then there was a hooker and a prop out in the defensive line, and they knew the try was going to be theirs if it went through the hands. So Jason Robinson gets his 10th try on tour after scoring 5 against the Queensland Presidents 15.
Well, 10 metres out, the defence is obliged to take the ball carry. You just can't hang off. So Walker had to go in. It's a shame that Moore didn't come wide and out.
It's hard to believe this player was stretched off last week down in Melbourne in huge agony. And here he is tonight setting up that try and attempting to convert the goal.
So the Lions scrum, asserting an early dominance, and now Johnny Wilkinson with the chance to put his side in front for the first time. How good is that? It cleared the crossbar by 15 metres. Lions hit the lead here at Stadium Australia.
The classic counter. Beautiful try. End of conversion. The Lions are back.
Well, the Lions certainly had a scrum dominance in the first test. Australia made changes to the front row, but the Lions have found a few creaks in the early stages. This is Danny Grucock. Johnny Ills went high. And Wilkinson with Matthew Burke. And Kepu up towards halfway. Henderson the tackler. They'll try and hold him up here and make it a collapse more, but Australia have lost it. And there's another overlap that emerged and closed. Advantage over. That's Vickery. So the Australian defence regroups. Henderson.
Number 9.
And George Gregan. Moving forward offside, and a penalty here for the Lions.
George Gregan was held down and basically got up in an offside position and naturally went in to try and defend, but referee nabbed him.
When you can apply that sort of pressure, you deserve to get the turnover.
So a chance now for Johnny Wilkinson to put the Lions even further in front. They lead 10-9. The Lions have 66% of territory so far and 67% of the possession, and they're now ahead on the scoreboard by 10-9 with the prospect of more to come here. His leg was in plaster last Sunday. Again, no problem with the distance. It's pushing that one out. So breathing space for the Wallabies after they got away to a 9-3 lead.
Andrew Walker with the ball. Should be going long.
Here's Scott Quinnell, 12 from halfway, with a head of steam into Smith, who brought him to ground brilliantly. Now there, Scott Quinnell tried to get to his feet. He was held in the tackle.
If the tackle's completed, there was a player around his legs. He went to ground with the ball. He's got to release it immediately or get to his feet before he plays. There, it's down. It's completed. Look, he gets back up and tries to play on again. You don't know the rules, son.
Unless he felt that he couldn't feel the hands of George Smith.
Give
But he's made the mistake, Scott Pennell, but his attitude is terrific. Just loves to punch that ball up.
Well, he's been brought down in two copybook tackles by Andrew Walker and George Smith so far. But he's been getting in behind the Australian defence when the opportunity is there. Harrison, that's sloppy work. Lions have pinched Australia's ball. Here's Dawson, brought to ground by John Eales. Gregan through quickly on Duff at James. Matt Dawson, the former England captain, now at scrum half. Wilkinson goes wide to O'Driscoll, the step up. Well, he beat three. Gregan wrapped him up. That's the 22-metre line. And that was Tom Smith, the loose head prop, kicking downfield. Here's Joe Robb. He skewed it. Dawson. Smith the tackler. The Lions just short of halfway here. Scott Pennell edges ahead. Danny Grucock to halfway. Well, the intensity and desire certainly there from this Lions team this week after capitulating in the second half in Melbourne. Here's Burke. And that's a good clearing kick by Matthew Burke to within seven at the halfway line in his 50th test match.
Excellent variety coming from the Lions here tonight in Sydney. Using plenty of options out there, whether it be the little kick through, but invariably spreading it light as well.
They're also picking out the men that they want to take out. Smith aimed up on by Grucock, and then the kick to where Joe Roff wasn't. Good thoughtfulness by the Lions.
Well, the Lions have lost their line-out throw now. George Smith pouncing on the loose ball. And then a player leaving his feet.
Well, isn't there some feeling out this game? No punches thrown. Let's hope that's not the case, but it's boiling.
So Andrew Walker coming up, and what about that stat of territory, Simon, with the possession?
Well, given the scoreline 10-9, the Australians have done well.
You've got to apply pressure on your opponents and use territory and possession against them to mount that pressure. The Wallabies can't seem to get out of their own half. It's because the defence of the Lions is great.
So there, Quinnell was penalised for leaving his feet as the ball came out. Throw over the back from Foley. And the Lions have pinched it. But initially they've lost forward.
Huge tackle there on Keith Wood. It's the third time tonight the Australians line out goes astray.
Nick Stiles sweeping around the back as the spare, and he's nailed Woods. Now back to the scrum. It continues the battle.
Here's Gregan and Roth. Pass lost ahead there by Dan Herbert. It wasn't a sympathetic pass though, and surprised Herbert. So just a little lack of cohesion there from the Australians.
Wallaby back, stack left. The attempted scissors doesn't work out.
Scott Pennell again into George Gregan. Gregan quickly to his feet. Wilkinson on his right boots. He's equally adept, whether it be left or right. And he's taken play over halfway, Johnny Wilkinson, who passed Rob Andrews' test scoring point record. Andrew played 71 tests. Wilkinson only in his 30th test match.
It'd be a good idea for the Wallaby forwards to go to more simple lineouts. Being overly complicated, and they got into problems. 8 turnovers in the game for the Australians, 4 for the Lions.
Justin Harrison, well. Flatley and Gray. Here's Herbert. Wilkinson underneath, Henderson over the top. Flatley again. Quick hands from Burke to Roth. Walker's coming through. Desperate Lions defence. Smith was there. Harrison just trying to settle things now. Lions have come in. Have they been able to steal the ball? I think they have. George Smith, I think, has come through offside. So there was some great work there. I think it was Neil Back who pinched the ball at the breakdown when Australia had it.
And Neil Back came in about 6 inches off the ground and just drove forward and snouted, got it.
There's a fantastic contest going on for the breakdown. Just zeroing in, firstly Smith, then Back, and the big men either side smashing any beside him out of the way.
So it was still a collapsed maul at this stage. No one wanting to let go. And still wasn't fully out, was the ruling by the ref. And George Smith penalised. Now Dawson sitting up here for Back, who's gone into scrum half. Wilkinson takes them on. Good defence in close. That was Owen Finnegan, the tackler. One off the ruck. Here's O'Driscoll. Still haven't made it to the halfway line. Nearly 30 minutes gone. Here's Andrew Walker. Counter-attacks on for the Aussies. Matthew Burke. Well, he had Joe Roth outside. He's elected to kick. Another chance for Walker here. Put it back down is the call. Well read by Wilkinson. Aussies are there with Gray and Walker. They want to hold him up here and force a turnover. It's a collapse maul. It is a turnover.
Well weighted kick there from Andrew Walker. Summed it up, put the ball through, got through on defence. Good work.
There's plenty going in at close quarters. Players looking to the touch judge to sort a few things out. There is no big pardons. Wilkinson tried to hold it up. He needs to wait for the support. Now he wants to get it down and back through his legs. And there's plenty in there.
So the two teams in a huddle here. And Australia clinging to a one-point lead, but it was always going to be an epic, and these two juggernauts are slugging it out here at Stadium Australia. Glenn Ella on the left, Rod McQueen and Ewan McKenzie, the Australian coaching staff that has performed such great deeds for the Wallabies. So there have been a lot of turnovers forced on both sides.
Don't even look at it.
Australia trying to edge back in the possession and territory stakes, but not too many missed tackles here tonight, certainly by the Australians.
Number two goals here, and I didn't get a number from Red.
So we're looking at penalty with no number.
So you heard that, Chris Handy?
Michael Foley got blutchered in the back of the head, I'm told, by a red player without a number. Hear the referee.
No, this chest on the knife edge, as you well know, okay? A bootman on the head there, no number identified, but can cost games. It's a penalty, correct to the boys, no number. Go away, Pete, go away, Pete.
So Paddy O'Brien, the referee, he's been seeing a sports psychologist since May to make sure he was on his game. He's also had a private fitness trainer, and he's doing a superb job here tonight. He's keeping the lid on proceedings. There hasn't been anything that's been malicious, but there was an illegality there as pointed out by the touch judge, and now Australia can get back in the lead.
Matthew Burke. Pressure, but he loves it. Flatley's only had three possessions tonight against Wilkinson with 11.
Wilkinson's missed just the one shot. Burke has been on the money with every attempt so far. And Australia hits the posts. Keith Woods. Let off for the Lions. They retain their one-point lead. Well, Keith Wood, there's nothing he can't do.
What a good clearance from Wood. You're right, Gordon. Cool.
What a great call, Gordy. It was just one of those moments. That ball looked like it was going through all money. And instead of hitting the front, it hit the face.
Finnegan at the back. Regan's built it. And a good option from Rock here, just to take the heat off. Australia not releasing the ball quickly enough. Joe Roth penalised.
He's going to like to see this one again. He placed the ball back pretty well,
but he's still holding onto it. So he got isolated. There wasn't the support. But he was still holding on. He had to leave it on the ground.
Once you're tackled and there's a player on his feet, you have absolutely no rights. Roth is still holding onto the ball there. He held on for a second or two. He can't. He must release it straight away.
And Martin Johnson, all over it. Big arms came through.
Now here's Keith Wood back in Munster. The locals like to touch his dome for good luck. Johnson at the front. Now they want to keep this on the ground. Collapsed by Australia. The Lions will take the advantage here. Wilkinson. Robinson's out wide. Here he comes, but Burke read it beautifully. It's still a penalty to the Lions, though, for the collapse maul.
It's a winning tactic for the Lions. They've used it all to it.
And it's a wonder the Wallabies aren't using it themselves, because the only way to defend against it. Now there, Johnson gives the ball to the back, and you can't pull down anyone in front. You can only tackle the man with the ball, as Rod Moore did there on Scott Quinnell. But everyone else playing a man in front of the ball is out of it.
So the Lions really looking to involve Jason Robinson, the turbocharged left wing, at every opportunity. Already they've gifted him a try out wide, but now Wilkinson looking to increase the margin to 4 points. ...22 years of age, playing in just his 30th test match. Normally so reliable, he missed with three, as we mentioned at Colonial last week in the first half, and Australia again off the hook.
The Wallabies definitely need good possession. Ruck and Moore count running 30-9. Scrum under pressure, line-out not working too well.
Aussies go deep. Here's Quinnell again. Just mishandling. And Matt Perry now, who played a centre against Australia in 98 in that 76-0 loss at Suncorp. Kefu's taken it over the 10-metre line. Flatley. Oh, a terrible knock-on by Henderson. Well, he'll have recurring nightmares about that one.
It wasn't a particularly good kick from Elton Flatley either. There, Graham Henry, Donald Lenihan.
Chris, we saw Andrew Walker drop a ball. A try resulted a few phases later. And now Henderson was, I think, thinking about that 22 and the opponents rushing up.
Yeah, it's hypercharged out here.
22-metre line, Gregan. Flatley, here's Walker, straightening. He's made 10. Regan again, hand on the ground there by the Lions. It's a penalty, and it's a deliberate penalty offence there by desperate Lions players.
Good covering defence from Quinnell. It wasn't him who put the hand in, it was O'Driscoll.
Just amazing when ball comes back free and it's available to play. You'll just see it so clearly. There it is. About to be picked up by Gregan, and then the Lions hand pulled both his arms and the ball away.
So we have about 4.5 minutes remaining before the break. The Lions leading Australia by 10-9. Burke's last kick hit the left-hand uprights. This is closer and easier, and it will put Australia back in the lead. But He's pushed it wide. So, nerves from the two kickers. 3 out of 5 for Burke, 2 out of 4 for Wilkinson. Lions still in the lead by 1. Uncharacteristic miss there by Burke. Harrison went high. Cregan goes in for Flatley. He's Kefu. Cregan again, Flatley, Gray. Hasn't seen much of the ball, Nathan Gray. Takes it ahead for Cregan. Inside ball for Finnegan. Kefu with a big step off his left foot. No, Driscoll and Tom Smith. Australia surging now. Great work by Cregan. Here's Walker. Roth and Herbert. Splendid try by the Australians down the short side. They held the ball through the phases. And George Gregan's skills there, absolutely masterful.
Well, Buddha, how do you see it? It's going off down there.
Look, George Gregan has got all the vision tonight and just directing it so brilliantly. Smith it was that took it deep into the Lions, and that created the trouble. Herbert handled first time, and Walker, a bit of magic. Wood looms. Herbert was there in support at the quick look over the shoulder. Go you, good thing, Danny Herbert.
Such smart play here from the Wallaby backs. They saw Keith Wood, Joe Roth, perfectly timed pass, 5 phases, and the key to the try was the George Gregan carry through from Owen Finnegan.
So now Matthew Burke, amidst the gold glitter, somehow finds a way through the confetti, and the Australians, from a 1-point deficit, a 6 clear.
What a remarkable turnaround. Wilkinson misses the penalty goal down here. Burke misses one, and then a converted try.
And Andrew Walker has redeemed himself, and it came from that missed kick by Rob Henderson. Knocking the ball on, and Australia pounced. Here's Burke.
Did a safety first there from the men in gold. Very close to half-time. They did have some room out there. Quinnell was moving up quickly.
And the Lions won't forget how important this is. They want to get on with it. They need a score before half-time. They've got to hit back quickly.
So Keith Wood up the back, taken by Corrie, that's Grewcock. George Smith underneath. Harrison over the top. Now Quinnell, caught by Moore in front. And those tacklers are held in there cleverly. Here's Henderson, straight through, Robinson! Henderson held on! Robinson pulling his hair out. The defence was there though, here's Johnson. Back, lovely hands for Wood. Back is there again. Dawson now, they can spread it. Here's O'Driscoll. Trying to straighten the attack. The Lions asking questions now of the Australian defence. Back to Martin Johnson. And back through his legs. Back at scrum half. Henderson getting that clean line break to get the momentum flowing. Penalty offence by the Australians. Here's Wilkinson. Back, such a clever ball player. That's Scott Quinnell. Dawson clears it, the Lions looking for the try. O'Driscoll, 2-on-2. Duffer James, and Herbert got him. There's Phil Vickery, what a tackle. Keith Woods. The Lions desperate for this 5-pointer. Elton Flatley, ball and all. Keith Wood again. What leg drive. The hoot has gone for half-time. Can Australia hold on? Wilkinson. Robinson. He had nowhere to go. They've kept it off the ground and driven ahead. Australia holding on desperately. Henderson. The Aussie backs are offside. Advantage being played. Foley and Stiles came through. Here's Dawson again. There's the pass to Smith. He went without it.
Number 8.
Now Darfur James is calling for the ball out wide here for a long kick to the touchline. And we saw 14 phases there from the Lions, and somehow Australia held them out.
Paddy O'Brien, great refereeing, played two phases of advantage out there, gave the Lions every opportunity to score. Finally, Totai Kefu gives the penalty away.
How come you know, with only a minute or so on the clock before half-time of the Lions' possession, that they're going to really have a crack?
Okay, Chris and Simon, here's our AXA angle, and we lose probably about a metre and 0.3 of the real goal width, but it's a handy distance at 30 metres and just a breath of wind out there. So this is a badly needed 3 points for Johnny Wilkinson and the Lions. They've called the tune in possession and territory, but they're behind on the scoreboard. But this will ease some of the pain. They threw the kitchen sink at Australia there just before the hooter. Kick successful. And the Lions are trailing by just 3 here at Stadium Australia. Herbert a try for the Wallabies. Robinson for the Lions. 16, plays 13.
Yes, well, Michael Slater hasn't got it quite right. It won't be a walkover. It's a titanic struggle. Pulsating contest. 16-13 to the Wallabies. Let's now analyse proceedings in that first half with former Wallaby flanker Gary Pearce. First two tests have been won in the first 10 minutes after half-time. Who will seize the moment? We'll be back shortly.
Colin Sharvis is on in 18 jersey. Gordon, that'll add a bit of spice to the side. I think he'll be on for Martin Corrie. Just trying to check the jersey numbers.
So number 18, Colin Sharvis from Cardiff. So two Welshmen in the back row now. He comes back after suspension at the Gabba. And Martin Johnson, you don't really have to be too much of a lip reader to work out what he's telling his Lions teammates. 40 minutes, death or glory.
In fact, Gordon, I think it's Scott Quinnell that's gone off and Sharvis is on, because Corrie is still on the field, as is Neil Back.
Well, they would have been in a bit of trouble if they had Quinnell still out there and Corrie off. So as you say, Chris, Corrie's a real workhorse, great work ethic.
One stat we didn't see in that table were turnovers, running 9 the Australians, 6 to the Lions.
So 40 minutes remaining. Johnny Wilkinson gets proceedings underway in the second half. One try apiece. Burke's goal kicking the difference so far. And there's Joe Roth. Andrew Walker hasn't got the touch. Walker comes through belatedly and is palmed off by Darfur James. 10-metre line Australian territory just ahead. Dawson then. Wilkinson. This is Perry. In behind the Aussie backs for Matthew Burke. And not happy with that kick. Going straight off the side of his boot. Big strike chance here for the Lions.
Excellent pressure there, Jason Robinson. Just hammered up the field. Burke looked up and there he was.
Well, what a great athlete he is, Chris Handy. Jason Robinson getting that first try, and he's a real eager beaver tonight.
He's got the acceleration of that Ford Cobra Mustang we both drove during the week, Gordy. And they are quick.
15 metres out. Referee playing advantage for a collapse mall. The Lions want to keep the ball here. Wilkinson composed. O'Driscoll. There was more offside by Australia in midfield. So if they don't score a try, they'll get the penalty kick. But they want the try. Henderson. Now Grewcock. Try-saving tackle from Andrew Walker. This is Robinson.
Hold on, be brave.
Now Wilkinson. Keith Woods. John Eales underneath. This is the Lions. Moments. Wilkinson with a short pass. Henderson. The Lions still have a big overlap on the right.
Todai Kefu trying to get out there. Wilkinson takes it. Just a steady build-up of pressure, and it did in the first test at the Gabba. The Lions have struck first after the break.
Well, this is a superb start to the second half for the Lions. On two occasions, the referee played advantage. Good refereeing. They kept on driving the big men up, whether it be Keith Wood, Corey, making inroads into the Wallaby defence. Here's Wilkinson. Just steps, little step. Todai Kefu. Herbert can't nail him.
Well, he vowed to come back after the mauling England got by the Wallabies in 1998. And what a man. He was crippled the start of the week, and now he's leading the fight back to victory.
And it's very interesting. Twice the Wallabies have been caught out with a prop forward defending against an overlap. Rod Moore that time was the first defender. Kefu had to come up and try and cover, but he committed himself too early. Johnny Wilkinson. What a lovely strike. And the Lions are out by four. Well, they scored 17 points in 12 minutes at the Gabba after halftime. Last weekend, it was the Wallabies who piled on the points after the break. And Wilkinson now giving the Lions a 7-point start in this second term.
Two miscues there on the kicking from the Wallabies. Put them under that pressure.
Here's Colin Chavis. Justin Harrison brought him to ground. Just out from the 22. So Johnny Wilkinson with a towering punt. Burke underneath. Halfway line ahead. Punches deep. Eels is following. Matt Perry gets the mark. You can only mark the ball on the full inside the 22.
Good chases there from the Lions. Gave Burke only one option to put it up.
And that one coming off the sides. So a little gain there for Perry. So the option, as it turned out, proving a fruitful one for Matthew Burke.
Now it's time for the Wallabies to get their line out working well. They need good quality possession to get the backs moving. I haven't really been able to involve them. They're going to score. They must do it.
Justin Harrison. Here's Nathan Gray. And Finnegan out wide. Smashing into the Lions three quarters. Numbers here for Australia. Walker. Driven backwards. Gregan. Flatley. Through a dummy. And was collared. Chavis coming in. Here's Foley. Straight into his opposite number, Keith Woods. Wallabies clean out. Great pass to Finnegan from Gregan. Chavis. Finnegan back through his legs. 2 metre line. Flatley again. They're queuing up. Herbert. Gray cleans out. Lions come over the top there through Corey. Referee's happy. Gregan. Flatley. Joe Roth's out here. Big palm off from Flatley. Slip the ball away, but now they can. Well, look at the offensive tackling and pressure from the Lions. Gregan recovers well. Harrison, overlap. That's Nathan Gray. And he's kicked it to Perry. So not a great option there by Nathan Gray. Here's Andrew Walker. 10 from halfway. And all the coolness you like from Andrew Walker. The experienced heads. Lions play on quickly. Chavis, not his best kick. Knocked back from Foley. Now Gregan. Here comes Joe Roth. Gregan. Dawson went to the mark. Spilt the ball.
11. Dawson is having a very good game for the Lions. But on this occasion, in come the Lions forward. Seal it off. A penalty to the Wallabies.
Colin Chavis is in everything right from the start from the... for the Lions since he's come on as a reserve. And you just have to continue to put teams under pressure. The Wallabies have coughed it up and then they've put the Lions back under pressure. Chavis keen to show why he should have been in the run-on team.
So the Wallabies are going to go for the try.
This is a good move. They need to keep this Lions defence under pressure. Defence from both sides has been outstanding.
The Wallabies opting not to kick the goal. They want seven. Michael Foley. Owen Finnegan at the front. Now can the Wallabies get their driving more going? That's Foley in control at the back. Lions mustn't pull it down. But the Wallabies don't do it as well as the Lions. Johnson will try and hold him up and turn him. Nick Stiles trying to get it back. Well, put that down to the defence of Martin Johnson. The Australians have squandered their opportunity, but a titanic piece of defence from Johnson, whose grandfather was an amateur wrestler.
It's a good observation, Gordon. The Wallaby forwards just haven't got that driving maul to the same degree of perfection as the Lions.
Stay on. Fellas, let's work on it. Hold. Engage. Go. Leave it. Down, other side. Break.
So going down on the far side. Take us through it, Chris.
Well, Paddy O'Brien's going to have his hands full here. The Lions will want to stay stable here.
Controlled at the back there. And some great work by Martin Corrie, but no ground for the Lions. Rob Henderson just cussing. Another shot here for the Wallaby lineouts.
And they've got to mount that same pressure again. They've got to make it work this time. And it's not the ball carrier, it's the men off the ball that create that drive forward. Firstly, they've got to secure the lineout.
Harrison's the money man. Gregan. Gray tries to smash through. Gregan again. Kefu. That's the goal line. Gregan wants it quickly. Here it is. It's a try number two for Daniel Herbert.
This is a sensational try from the Wallabies. They put a lot of thought into it. Harrison, the two-handed ball at number four, down quickly. And then Nathan Gray coming like a rocket, got him across the first lot of advantage line, and then it was Kotai Kefu. Watch it, Harrison, sheer, two balls down.
Sheer desperation, this. Look at how they hit the line and then strive to go forward. They pick up the short man, Kefu just about crawls over the line. It's hit up again. Look, Foley, not selfish. Herbert, you're guilty.
Well, again, the world-class skills of George Gregan. A beautiful pass from the line-out. It was a couple of metres in front of the runner, and then that fast lightning clearance to the left-hand side, and the Lions outflanked.
Psychologically so important, the Wallabies scored that try. They had to get that after being down there twice.
The lead has changed five times. Australia with their noses in front. By two more. Unbelievable kick there by Matthew Burke. Look at Glenn Ellerand, Rod McQueen, the Aussie coach, watching on in his last test match.
We have got a ball game. Two fabulous second half tries have ignited this stadium.
So Justin Harrison. And lost there by Owen Finnegan, I think. It was tapped down by Harrison. Finnegan just lost the ball down to ground. Referee says it travelled forward.
Well, Harrison just needed to keep that ball in hand with that pressure coming through. They hit him, the ball went down, wasn't accurate.
Well, just these little mistakes have opened the window for the opposite team. Look at the overlap here. O'Driscoll! That is a very ugly tackle by Daniel Herbert. And I think he might be spending some time in the sin bin.
Get back in, which means you've got to kick them down, okay?
Yeah, I couldn't help it.
He must kick them down, yeah. The yellow card. No, he took them high. It's a yellow card. High.
So a dramatic turn in this pulsating test match. Daniel Herbert in the sin bin for 10 minutes. 51 minutes gone.
Yep, well, you just can't argue against that. He deserves the time in the bin.
Two tries and 10 minutes in the bin. And in real play, the power of those two players coming together. And it did look ugly.
This 10 minutes, the Wallaby forwards must be absolutely hungry for possession.
So this to level the scores. And not a problem for Johnny Wilkinson. There are masses of red jumpers behind the goalposts at either end. The Lions supporters salute deliriously. It's 23 all.
Well, one wonders if this was drawn at full time, whether the Australian Rugby Union had followed Wimbledon's and come back Monday. We might have another one.
Well, put it down to Brian O'Driscoll's brilliant stepping. Came back inside, he forced the error from a desperate Dan Herbert. There was no malicious intent in the tackle, it was just high around his throat. And the referee had no choice to send him to the sin bin. Here's Colin Chavis. He's made an impact since he's come on. But Australia's a man down now. Can the Lions take advantage? Matt Dawson. Wilkinson's kick very close to touch. Burke lets it bounce. Here's Robinson up again. Burke's in trouble. Smith is back there. So is Walker. And Australia's done well. Here's Flatley. And Keith Wood here. Covering at the back. What's he going to do? Play on, says the referee. He collided with Nathan Gray. Now a huge torpedo from Walker. Perry out from his 22. He's got to keep the ball in play. And he replies with interest. Now Burke inside the 22 and just using a banana trajectory has taken play over halfway.
An experienced player, Burke, needed to get that ball into touch. Time ticking away.
Okay, there's an injury here for Keith Wood. The score is 23 all. So Keith Wood, the former bank official with the Irish Permanent Building Society, now has his own public relations company. But no PR there from the Aussies.
Well, Flatley's only had 13 possessions in this game against Wilkinson, well over the 20.
So Herbert's been off for a couple of minutes. Giant and Johnson at the front. He was pulled to ground. That was okay because there was no more form. Here's Keith Wood. Crunching tackle by Kefu. Number three is Phil Vickery. Dawson clears. Wilkinson dances. He got through Styles, but George Smith wrapped him up. Australia have it. Gregan counter. Kefu and Walker. The pass behind him. Andrew Walker had set his sights for the goal line. And Todai Kefu knows it.
Terrific tackle back on Kefu.
Walker holds that ball. The try was on Chris Handy.
He's just overrun it. I think Kefu got it as quickly as he could across his body. Walker was right on them on the advantage line.
Well, he does explode onto the ball, Walker. Now here's Perry in from fullback. He's crunched out there. Again, well read by the Aussie defence. And they forced a turnover. Australia still looking for it. They get the penalty. Well, there was a grand tackle there by Nathan Gray, and the penalty has been turned around against Rod Moore.
He's coming, just coming out.
We're just listening to the referee here, Paddy O'Brien.
It's okay, just hold in, hold in.
Paul Honus wanting to come in as well here, the touch judge on this side.
Number three, after the whistle.
After the whistle on Ritzy.
Absolutely, thank you. John.
This was after the whistle.
They're not allowed to kill your ball, which they did. So I go penalty. He's not rucking, you trampled him. Don't do it. He had a penalty right out in front. I'm changing it. Be very careful.
So Rod Moore, in only his third test match, ruining his indiscretion.
can't afford.
Could have been a possible goal kick there, Chris Handy.
Yeah, you can't afford the rush of blood incensed by the player coming offside. And I don't think Rod Moore was the worst of it, but he pulled him out. Was after the whistle.
Yes, it was pretty harmless stuff, but the ball was well away. That was the problem for Rod Moore, so again, he was in no man's land. Can't rake the man like that, even though there was nothing nasty in it.
It was a critical opportunity for Australia with one man down to add some points. Paddy O'Brien told John Eales, and I'm sure he knows it now, Lions on attack.
Big line out for Johnson. Neil Back comes in, and here's the famous driving maul. They could take this 25 metres. They're still going.
You have to drive this maul sideways. You can't stop it.
They're trying to pull it sideways now, but Neil Back had it. Now they clear it. They've sucked in the defenders. Who's out wide? Wilkinson goes himself. There were four Lions players on two. And has Australia forced a turnover?
Turned it over.
Courageous stuff. Andrew Walker, again, wanting to clear that ball 40 metres down the field. It comes off the side of his boot. I think George Smith pilfered another one there.
He did, and Neil Back, the centre of that driving maul from the Lions. They've got to get in there and try and target him. He's more, the core of it.
More of the same here, Buddha?
Yeah, more of the same. Exactly the same stuff. Why change it? Keep it in there until you've got numbers out wide.
Again, Australia's gone down to collapse it, but the maul didn't collapse. So the referee's playing advantage, though. It's going to be a penalty.
Putting the maul down.
Again, it was Rod Moore this time round. A good transfer, a very clever transfer from Johnson to Grewcock, and then they drive it.
Okay, well, the score here is still locked at 23-all, but a successful kick from Wilkinson will put the Lions back in the lead. So Wilkinson lining this one up. He's only 7 metres in from the touchline. The lead set to change again for the seventh time, if successful. Worm's eye view and excruciating result for the Lions. Score remains at 23-all. Wilkinson 5 from 8. And about 3.5, 4 minutes left for Daniel Herbert.
There'll be no hurry from the Australians in getting this ball kicked out.
Just make that about 3 minutes for Daniel Herbert. Still it's 23-all. 3.5 minutes remaining. So here's Perry coming in from fullback. It's Stafford James, in fact, the Welshman, who was dropped for this test, but Austin Healy pulled out this morning. Now the Lions spread it wide with numbers and Neil Back. And here's Robinson and Walker. Walker missed him and then came again. So did Matthew Burke. Look at the overlap on the right. 3-on-1. 2-on-1. Duffer James. Australia drift across. Now they'll come back the other way. The Wallaby defence having to dig deep here. Danny Grewcock into Moore. Keith Woods. Tripped over. Just lost his footing. And Australia knocked on.
Well, this is the last thing the Wallabies want, to have a scrum here. George Smith will have to drop out of the scrum to make up for Daniel Herbert.
I think Keith Wood lucky not to get pulled up for knocking the ball on. I think Paddy O'Brien must have looked behind him.
So the score here is 23-all. So the scrum to go down. And Daniel Herbert keen to get back out on the field.
Oh.
Will this be the turning point of the match? Australia a man down. And wasting valuable seconds.
Gentlemen, shut up.
George Smith into the scrum. Down a man in defence.
1 minute and 20 seconds to go for Daniel Herbert in the sin bin.
The Lions are stacked to the left. Very deep.
Somehow Australia's got to hold on here, and Michael Foley is milking it for every second he can.
You see this Lions back line so deep. Daniel Herbert still off the field, trying to set up the overlap.
How does Australia hold on here, Chris Handy?
Well, it's an arm wrestle, Gordon. I've never seen anything quite like it. It's a total scrap in the forwards. Even a look is enough to kill you out there. Just not wanting to give an inch because they know it'll mean plenty. Now the scrum has to be good first for the Wallabies and for the Lions. And then they scramble.
Now they can go wide. It's a great pass and it was dropped by O'Driscoll. Lost behind. If he'd held on there, the Lions would have scored. They still have possession. And it's a turnover.
This could be the turning point of the game.
Nathan Gray, you little beauty. He wrapped himself around Dafydd James and that ball trapped between the two bodies.
The Lions just needed to complete this backline movement and they were there, and O'Driscoll, the most dangerous man in the back line, drops it.
So, Todai Kepu from the base of the scrum. Will that prove to be the turning point? And George Gregan has knocked the ball on at the base of the scrum. Well, that's amazing. He tried to pick it up. It just shows you the amount of pressure on everyone out there. He's got his hands on it, and it slipped. And there was a foot in the way. I think it was John Eel's foot. He had to try and lift it over the foot. So the Lions can apply the blowtorch again. There's still a man up. And there, Corrie's caught. So too is Dawson. Opportunism from Australia again. Can they force another turnover? Now the Lions will try to exploit it. Robinson's wrapped up. With a man up, can the Lions take advantage? Wilkinson sandwiched. And Stiles is in to pinch it. Australia back in possession. The Lions leave their feet. Referee says play on. Here's Smith.
Going off your feet.
Well, what application. What intensity from the Wallabies at the breakdown.
Well, it's all about composure, Simon, and it's coming in large doses from the Wallabies.
Lions are starting to lose a bit of their form out there. They can sort of sense that victory, but they're starting to relax their attack.
So Dan Herbert is back on the field. The Wallabies have a full complement, and somehow they've managed to defend their territory.
Well, the hand-to-hand combat at close quarters has swung in the Wallabies' favour. They are really out there scrapping for it. George Smith is all over it. Frustration there for the Wallabies trying to clear it. It ends up in a penalty. Now they've got to turn it into something special.
So Wilkinson taking a bad option there. He got isolated. And Stiles was Johnny on the spot. 23 all. It's deadlocked. Justin Harrison. And here's Gray again. And Finnegan. He's the battering ram in midfield. Harrison now, in close, straight into Vickery. Gregan, Foley, tries to bump off Wilkinson. Gregan and Gray. Landed just inside the touchline. Nathan Gray's got it on a piece of string tonight.
Now he's gone out. Paul Honus has called it out.
Yeah, it landed just inside the touchline. And so it's a line-out throw here for the Lions.
Well, this is critical. This is somewhere where Harrison can be effective and Eels competing for the ball.
Grewcock's going to the back, number five. Eels was there, got pushed out. Eels got pushed out. It's a penalty. And I tell you what, John Eels milked that one for all it was worth.
Quite an amazing tactic there from the Lions to throw it long.
Well, it was shades of Andy Hayden at Carter Farms Park in 1978. Penalty here, Australia, 23-all. It's a cliffhanger here at Stadium Australia. There's about 15 minutes to go. The crowd has burst into Waltzing Matilda. Matthew Burke with an important kick here that will put the Wallabies back in the lead.
No one on the bench is warming up. No replacements looking likely at this stage. Important kick.
He's the man for the moment. What a kick by Burke, his fourth penalty. He's also kicked two conversions for a personal tally of 16 points. Australia 26-23. Johnny Wilkinson goes quickly. Harrison underneath. Wallabies secure it. So, I was going to say, Simon, there's one interesting point here. The Lions have not scored a point in the last quarter of the first and second test matches. Australia has their noses in front here by three.
Especially consider with Herbert being off the ground 10 minutes in the sin bin, but it's got to be a good scrum here to get it downfield.
There's a big shunt from the Lions, a second shove. Australia stand their ground. He's Gray. What a stormer from Gray to the 10-metre line. Gregan, flatly. Well, he wanted more angle on that kick. Also, men in support on the outside. Portland, Australia stays positive in this situation, and Burke, with all his experience again, has taken it almost to the 10-metre line.
Well, a pretty poor kicking option taken by Alton Flatley, and I think they'd be shaking their heads up there a little bit. And right in the balance now, Lions forced to struggle to go to strange calls in the line-out. Need to settle it down.
The disarray again, John Eels. So the Lions break down in communication. Finnegan goes to ground. Johnson the tackler. Gregan screaming for it. The ball's there for Australia. Flatley, Walker. Well, he had nowhere to go, and Nathan Gray was on hand. Good morning from him. Here's Daniel Herbert. Great tackle by Tom Smith, the mobile Scotsman. Kefu now at Johnson. Flicked the pass up in the tackle as he went to ground. 10-metre line, Lions territory. Flatley again to Walker, who was cut out. This is Gray. Corey the tackler. Neil back number seven. Back for Gregan. And Finnegan. Keith Woods. Gregan again. Well, there was an offside player, a lazy runner. Accidental. The referee says, let's keep going. He didn't really interfere. Now Walker. Now Herbert. Now Roth. Perry to beat. Joe Roth. Darfur James there first. It was carried over the goal line. It's a 5-metre scrum to Australia.
Sensational patience there from the Australians. Just punched it up, and then they got the overlap. They got it to the speed man, the magician Joe Roth. What's he do? He puts the ball ahead and forces now the 5-metre scrum.
Oh, the knot in the stomach. Lions supporters and Wallaby supporters as well. Desperate defence for the red jerseys as Matt Cobain comes on. Probably Finnegan will come to the line.
Well, what a classic test match we're seeing here. It's been billed as the war between two hemispheres, the Rugby World Crown at stake here. And the crowd, over 84,000, semaphored on the scoreboards. 84,188, that's the capacity here with the reconfiguration. Can the Lions now stand their grounds? The Wallabies have a spring in their step. They went through nine phases to get to here. Kepu now for Gregan. And Flatley. And Gray. Pizroff. Way they go quickly for Gray. And Walker has to release.
No! Seven!
Number seven, George seven. Smith, coming in on the side of the tackle. Referee was right there.
From the wide ball to Andrew Walker. Got a little bit isolated. George Smith coming in desperately to try and secure the ball. Walker did very well to get the ball back. But the red jumpers everywhere. Watch him. Down he goes.
Now in the tackle, the referee has judged there that Smith came on the side, which he certainly did. You have to come back around behind the last feet. So absolutely correct. And the penalty for the Lions takes them outside the 22.
And Darren Morris, the prop forward, comes on. And also Ian Bolshaw, he comes on for Scotland's Tom Smith. Time to bulk up that scrum.
Keith Wood up the back. Corey was there. So, who wants it the most? Just under 10 minutes remaining. Johnson and Morris with Grucock. So the fresh legs coming on for both sides. Matt Dawson there, Australia, competing ferociously at the breakdown. But the Lions going forward prior to the stoppage. They will get the scrum feed, 10-metre line.
Lowen Finnegan off. He's had a good game. Watch this. Look at the contesting at the breakdown. Matt Cobain on.
Australia by three. Corey goes down, so does Cobain. There for Dawson. Wilkinson. Here's Robinson, Flatley the tackler. Harrison came in. Flatley goes again for his second tackle in a row. Here's Johnson. John Eales underneath.
Think about it.
Robinson, big overlap here. Gregan, ball and all. Just short of halfway. Australia has it. Looks like Todd Ikefu. It looks like Todd Ikefu stole the ball. He did. And the penalty going against the Lions. Neil back offending. Martin Johnson. His Leicester teammate being called out.
Right, Martin. That's the warning one, okay? Any more of that when we're clip ball, we're going yellow. Go back. That's it, warning.
Well, Neil Back was once suspended for pushing over the referee in the cup final at Twickenham. But he's a fantastic player, 32 years of age. He hopes to be back to the World Cup in 2 years' time. Eight minutes to go. And a line-out now for the Wallabies.
Just look at the intensity there, and Neil Back off the ground just impedes that ball to Gregan.
Justin Harrison plucked away by Gregan to Gray. Now Herbert comes in to clean out Gregan. Burrows. It's Michael Foley joined by Kepu. Lions have been able to slow down the delivery here. It's out in front of the goalposts. They must defend here. Australia just showing a lot of patience and composure. Something the Lions didn't show when they had an extra man. Kepu. They're just working away in close. Gregan. Flatley. Roth. Just caught by O'Driscoll by the bootlace. 8 metres out. Gregan again. Walker. Kepu, the Lions throwing themselves into the fray here. They have to hold on. Dan Herbert with two tries against his name tonight. Seventh phase for Australia. Flatley, Matt Cobain. Cobain does well. Still they go short sides. That's the goal line ahead for Australia. Gregan in. So too was Johnny Wilkinson to steal it. The Lions are still breathing. 10 phases for the Wallabies. Desperate gallantry from this Lions team, but here's Roth now. Will he attempt the drop goal? He's going to take it up to the 22. And Australia, because it was just a tackle,
will get the scrum feed out in front of the goalposts.
The concentration at the breakdown, 1-15 from the Australians, is just remarkable. They are making so few mistakes with such huge pressure coming through for the men in red.
Although Rob Henderson for the Lions is visibly groggy, and Nathan Gray down.
So the score here, Buddha, is 26-23 in a nail-biter. So now George Gregan from the scrum. Back for Gregan. And Herberts. 26-23. Player handling the ball on the ground.
Colin Sharvis had done all the good work, made the tackle, competed for the ball, but then when it was released, he was on the ground. You can't then play it and put it back on your side. He's disappointed. Wonderful opportunity for Matt Burke. He's kicked sensationally tonight.
Well, there are still some more dramatic twists remaining in this game. Ninth ruck penalty against the Lions.
Rumble! Rumble!
Matthew Burke. This to put Australia out by six with just 4 minutes to go. The Lions would have to score a converted try to take the lead. And Burke makes no mistake. That's his fifth penalty to chalk up his 19th points. And Australia by six inside the last 4 minutes. So the Lions need 7 points to hit the lead and possibly take this series. Australia has never beaten the Lions in a test series in 102 years. Gregan's kick is a searching one. Perry at the back is wrapped up by Gregan. It was a smother tackle, so the Lions retain the scrum feed. Because that was a kick in general play, the smother tackle means that the Lions can hold onto the ball.
Great thinking by George Gregan, though, to try and hold the man up. But you're quite correct, Gordy. Possession to the Lions, an opportunity to strike.
Well, we saw the French snatch a dramatic victory in the World Cup semi-final in Sydney in 1987. Can the Lions do it here? Jason Robinson looming out wide. Henderson was trying to get some space for the little winger. And ripping the ball out on the tackle. Dawson now. And his teammate saying, go for touch. If we score 7 points, we can win the game. The Lions snatched it in injury time against the Brumbies at Bruce Stadium. Can they repeat it here? Australia by six. It was Matt Dawson who kicked the winning goal. And now the Lions, with the opportunity for a driving maul, are just 10 metres out. A converted try would give them the lead.
Look at this crowd. Absolutely on fire.
Martin Johnson, and it's been pinched at the front by Harrison. Shades of Mark Connors at Westpac Trust Stadium against the All Blacks last year. Amazing.
Well, Justin Harrison, you've earned your keep. What a wonderful jump. In front, right in between the hands of Martin Johnson. He'll be filthy. They called him innate. They called him Neanderthal. I call him you good thing.
Here's Grewcock then. He's taken straight to ground legally. So the Lions not able to get their driving more going. Here's Woods into Smith. Harrison came from behind the big lock to tackle. Dawson threw a dummy. That's Morris. Or Vickery. And they've forced a turnover. Heartbreaker for the Lions. Andrew Walker produces a booming punt kick. And the Aussies out of jail. We're inside the last minutes. Will this be the fairy tale ending for all-conquering Wallaby coach Rod McQueen?
Well, there's an 89-year-old woman in Brisbane that would be delighted to see the Wallabies win the first series against the Lions for 102 years. She was born in 1912 and has waited a long, long time.
So the Lions get it. They're still alive. But they have to do it with a converted try to snatch the series now. Here's O'Driscoll. He's dangerous. His heels. And Smith. Well, he beat several tackles there. And Australia stretched out wide. There's an overlap. Here's Henderson.
Come out, go!
Taken there by Elton Flatley. The Wallaby defence regroups. They punch away on the short side. Wilkinson, Foley. Overlap. The try's on for James. Cregan arrives. The hoot is gone. It's general play. And this is it for Australia. The Lions roared loudly. But the Wallabies soared higher. Dramatic finish. Unbelievable test match here at Stadium Australia. Wallabies 29, Lions 23. The Tom Richards Trophy comes down under. Well, what a great performance by this Wallaby team. And what a courageous resistance and assault from the Lions of Britain and Ireland. They gave it their all, but it was the turnovers that cost them dearly. And again, for the third time in the series, the Lions have not scored a point in the last 20 minutes. Well, for drama and raw excitement, it's hard to imagine a better test match. Let's now hear from the winning skipper, who's with Simon Poitevin.
John Eales, congratulations. A fantastic win. The defence was just unbelievable.
Thanks, Porto. It was a bloody good effort. You know, to come back from 1-0 down and a bad 1-0 down and to win it, it's a great credit. You know, especially when you have to make some changes. Justin Harrison comes in, plays like that. Elton Flatley under pressure. It's a great effort from the whole squad.
Is this the hardest series you've ever played in your life?
It's so hard to say that. I mean, it's the hardest one this year so far. But it was a tough series and one that we're extremely proud about winning. And I suppose that, you know, on behalf of the team, I'd certainly like to wish Rod McQueen the best. He's been a great ambassador for us. He's really shown us the way over the last few years. And his legacy will last a long time.
And he'll be a special hero to the series, George Gregan, just remarkable.
Hey, George is outstanding. I mean, he just continually produces performance, great performance after great performance, and just great, so great to play with him.
Well, on behalf of everyone here tonight, around Australia, around the world, to you and Rod McQueen, congratulations.
Thanks, Porter.
And let's now go to Chris Handy.
Well, Martin Johnson, you brought a very proud team to Australia and you played some magnificent football. Disappointing?
Yeah, it's I'm very numb at the moment, but I couldn't ask for any more for the lads in terms of effort. We just didn't have quite enough at the end when push came to shove to win it, and that lived with us for a long time.
It was like hand-to-hand combat out there at real close quarters.
We knew we had to come out and play big after half-time, and we got the try. Just conceding that one about 10 minutes later kept them back in the game, and then it was anyone's game the last 20. We had a chance to win it, the same as them, and credit to them, they won it, deserved it, no excuses. Just like to thank our fans for coming over. I'm just sorry we couldn't do it for you.
Thank you, Martin. Thanks to the boys.
So there's Rod McQueen, and his achievements have been frozen in time, enshrined in rugby folklore. The Tom Richards Trophy is now held by the Wallabies for the first time. Let's find out who was the man of the match, because he's now with Chris Handy.
Well, George Smith, man of the match. What a classic game. It was tough in close there, wasn't it?
Yeah, it definitely was. British Lions type 5 and back row were really in there at the breakdown, clean out, and it was very tough out there.
Pleased to win?
Yeah, very pleased. You know, we've been working through this past couple of months, and
especially for Rod McQueen.
Yeah, definitely for Rod. He's been a great coach over the years. The record speaks for himself. So, yeah. Great, great.
Well, to the winners go the trophies from Bundaberg Distilling. Tony Scanlon with your Man of the Match award.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Thanks, Ricketts.
Congratulations. Go and join the boys.
Thanks a lot.
So George Smith from Cromer High School in Sydney. He is the toast of the Northern Peninsula. He is the toast of Australia, as is this man, Rod McQueen. What an achievement. What a record as coach. He can die happy, that's for sure. But he'll be now a consultant and helping various countries around the world. But John Eales and Rod McQueen, shades of Norm Provan and Arthur Summons in that classic photo. And the Aussie fans are just enjoying the moment here, as you are no doubt around Australia if you're a Wallaby supporter. But great credit to the Lions. The Wallabies pinched a lot of ball, five in the lineouts. Justin Harrison won three of those throws. He had an heroic test debut. The final score, Australia 29, the Lions 23. Moments in the history of Australian Rugby Union can be yours to own. John Eales and the kick. You can own this limited and commemorative frame photograph.
John Eales, new champion.
For the 2000 Bledisloe Cup. Only 500 were made, each individually numbered. Personally autographed by John Eales, authenticated and officially licensed by Australian Rugby. Phone this number now to reserve your piece of Wallaby history. George Gregan, the Australian vice-captain, he didn't get man of the match, but I tell you what, he was right up there. He was the leading tackler for the Wallabies tonight with 16. He produced a sensational performance. The jubilation and the sheer elation of this historic moment for the Wallabies. Simon Poitevin is an emotional wreck. The Wallabies have won here, Simon, by 29-23 to win their first ever series over the Lions.
Historic, gutsy, just from both sides, a tremendous game. But for the Australians, they dug so deep late in the game, especially with Herbert off the field.
Well, looking at the scorers, Herbert, two tries, and Matthew Burke with another big point-scoring performance. That's 44 in two matches for him. And the Lions, well, Wilkinson missed three kicks at goal, and they were vital, but it still was Australia by 6 points. Now, let's have a look at these stats, and Simon, take us through them.
Well, even more remarkable there, if you look at the possession that the Lions had out there, the number of tackles the Australians had to make. The line-outs really started to work very well in the second half of the Australians, and the line breaks started to come their way as well.
Okay, let's now join the presentation here at the Olympic Stadium. And we're going to join the president of the Australian Rugby Football Union, a former Wallaby himself, a very proud Wallaby, Peter Criddle.
Support. You've been a wonderful support for your tour. You've been a wonderful backup for your team. You've made this series even more enthralling. Well, it was a wonderful finish. Somebody said about taking chances, when you're skating on thin ice, you might as well tap dance. That's what our boys did tonight, and they won. Well done, John Eales. Well done, Australia. Can I ask the captain of the British and Irish Lions, Mr. Martin Johnson, to come up to the podium? Thank you, Martin.
Can you have a few words for Martin? I'd just like to say I thought it was a tremendous series. Three great games of rugby. It came down to the last test, and Australia won the game. No excuses from us, they deserve to win it. I'd like to thank our fans for their excellent support for the whole tour. I'd like to wish John and the Wallabies good luck for the Tri-Nations and the rest of the season. And finally, I'd like to thank our players. I couldn't have asked for any more in terms of effort. It's been a long, hard tour, and we came up just short. But you can be proud of yourselves. We're just sorry we didn't win. Sorry. Thank you.
Kind words. Now I'd like to ask the chairman of Bundaberg Distilling,
company, Mr. Tony Scanlon, to step forward, please.
On behalf of Bundaberg Rum, this is the first time that we've been associated with such an event, and we're delighted to be associated with the winning Wallabies in the three test series against the British Lions. We thank the Lions for their great games over the last 3 weeks. It's been a tremendous series, and we couldn't have asked for a better start to our sponsorship. And on behalf of Bundaberg Rum, congratulations to John Eales, Rod McQueen and the Wallabies. And would John Eales please come forward?
It's great to have you here. I think it goes without saying that every time you are here supporting us that we actually win. So you are our lucky charm. But on behalf of the Wallabies, initially I'd like to thank Martin and his boys for such a great series. I think it's, you know, without a doubt one of the best series that any rugby followers have ever seen, and just made all the more special by the number of supporters that have come out to support your team. And it's certainly the standard of support was set in Brisbane by the Lions supporters, and then I think after we gave the Australian supporters a bit more to cheer about in Melbourne and here in Sydney, I think certainly we're very proud of the efforts of you guys, and we thank you for all your support. With the Australian team, I'd just like to make special mention of a few players. Justin Harrison, who played his first test tonight. Matt Burke, who played his 50th test tonight. And of course, extra special mention of Rod McQueen, a man who has taken the Wallabies over... Over the last 4 years, he ends his reign here tonight, but Rod, we certainly thank you for all your support throughout the last 4 years, and we're very pleased that we could send you off on a winning note. Thank you very much.
Rod McQueen.
Too much except to say I really respected the Lions. It is all about respect, and you're a great team. Thank you for the contest. To the Wallabies and John Eales, it's been a pleasure being involved with such a fine group of people over the last 4 years. And to everyone out there, it's bloody good to be Australian. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that wraps it up here tonight. In the presentations, we thank you very much for coming along here. And to all of our visitors, thank you. We ask you to take your time leaving the stadium. Please be careful if you're driving. Thank you very much.
Yes, the Wallabies have created history here tonight with this victory over the Lions by 29-23 to win the series by 2-1 after losing the first test at the Gabba. Great moment here for Australian rugby. Yes, and Tom Richards' grandson, Richard Mink, is here tonight, savouring the occasion. Justin Harrison, what about that line-out steal inside the Wallaby 22 near the end of the game? The Wallabies
basking in the glory of their triumph here and still working their way around Stadium Australia on this lap of honour. John Eales, Rod McQueen, and some great rugby action coming up in the Tri-Nation series, of course, here on the Seven Network. Next week we have South Africa and New Zealand. And check out our replay time. It's at noon, exclusively on Channel 7, next Sunday, July 22nd. And then a week later, the Wallabies, they can afford some celebrations, but only briefly because they're off to Fremantle to prepare before heading over to the High Veld. And they will play at Pretoria against the Springboks on July 29, 1 a.m. a live telecast. And Sports World tomorrow will feature Rod McQueen, a special feature, and Chris Handy will be live as part of the panel. And on i7 Sport, I'll be in a telephone box in the Snowy Mountains if you want to join me at 11 a.m. for a live chat. But it really has been a sensational night here for the Wallabies. They don't want to leave the field at the Olympic Stadium. They have given their coach, Rod McQueen, a triumphant send-off. It has been a stupendous performance. And on behalf of the Seven broadcast team here at Stadium Australia, please now join us for the Tri-Nation series. But congratulations to John Eales and Rod McQueen. It really was a blockbuster here tonight in Sydney.